sea lamprey are the largest of the three lamprey species found in Ireland. A protected species, they resemble eels in appearance but can grow up to 1 metre in length. They return to the Mulkear catchment from the sea in order to spawn, but they face many challenges within the river when attempting to migrate upstream. This is a challenge which MulkearLIFE has addressed with great success.
The juvenile sea lamprey or ammonites, once they hatch from the egg, they will seek out areas of mud and silt like the area behind us here. They'll burrow into the mud. They'll remain there for 5 to 6 years, filter feeding. After this time, they'll undergo a metamorphosis. They'll develop eyes, a sucker mouth, gills. They'll migrate to sea. They'll spend up to 2 years at sea off the coast in a parasitic phase, attaching to host fish. After 2 years, they'll return to rivers, not necessarily the river that they were born. They'll migrate as far up as they can in order to reach suitable spawning habitat. They'll excavate a red, similar to what trout and salmon will excavate, a bowl-shaped depression in the substrate. They'll spawn thousands of eggs. The majority of the eggs will permeate into the riverbed and they'll hatch after a couple of days. Obstacles such as the weir behind me have a negative effect on migrating species such as sea lamprey. It can deny them access to suitable spawning habitat further up in the catchment. We're interested in following the sea lamprey during their upstream migration in order to learn about their behaviour, how fast they move and how they cope with man-made obstacles, and ultimately to find the locations in which they ultimately spawn. So in order to radio tag the beasts, we have to catch them first of all.
The reason we had put radio tracking devices onto them was to see how they would negotiate Annacotty Weir and how they would negotiate Ballyclough Weir. What we found from that is, yes, some were achieving passage Annacotty, very limited numbers, but there was a major, major barrier at Ballyclough Weir. So that's what the radio tracking proved to us. And what it also proved to us is if they weren't achieving passage at Annacotty Weir, the first barrier, they were simply moving off. They were moving back down the Mulkear. So the radio tracking proved very useful in that regard. But what it also proved to us is that we had to do something at Annacotty and we had to do something at Ballyclough. So what we've been trying to do over the last number of years is to assess how sea lamprey have managed or not managed to get above the barrier at Annacotty. As a result of that, we designed a new tile. We worked in cooperation with fish pass experts in North America, in Europe, and we designed the very first sea lamprey tile that would work in an Irish context. And basically it's ABS plastic. It's a very hard plastic that's molded in a design that looks a bit like an egg box turned upside down. And simply what that does is it's attached to the face of the weir and it lowers the velocity of the water coming over the face of the weir, and the sea lamprey attach to the base and wiggle their way up. It's as simple as that. And what we've done since we installed those sea lamprey tiles at Annacotty, we've monitored their passage, and approximately 95 to 97% of all passage is now achieved on these two tiles. And it's phenomenal. The run that we've had this past 10 days has been remarkable. We've achieved passage with very, very significant numbers, upwards of 260 in the first 10 days of the run. Once we get them up over Annacotty Weir, we've opened up 184 kilometres of additional habitat. The second barrier was at Ballyclough Weir, and in the summer of 2013, we removed part of Ballyclough Weir, which again facilitated both salmon passage and sea lamprey passage. I think as the MulkearLIFE project comes to an end, the one thing we can say in relation to our work with sea lamprey is that we have achieved passage. We have addressed the barriers on the lower Mulkear. We have opened up this 184 kilometres of additional habitat. And thankfully this year, we have seen a massive run of sea lamprey, and that is very significant for us. We feel it's important in an Irish context, and indeed we feel it's important in a European context.
Sea lamprey face many obstacles during their upstream migration. In the Mulkear River, the two major barriers were Annacotty Weir and Ballyclough Weir. Specially designed lamprey tiles were placed on Annacotty Weir to assist the sea lamprey in achieving passage. In 2013, Ballyclough Weir, which was impassable to sea lamprey, was partially removed. Through this work, MulkearLIFE has opened up hundreds of kilometres of suitable spawning habitat for them.